Hi guys. Things are pretty wonky today. So everything's been pretty touchy trying to go live. So I'm just gonna get started. We're just gonna do some birdhouses, guys. You can do these cute little things. You can get elaborate. You can get very simple. You can do just however you would like. I already have paint on my palette from this morning, so I'm just gonna paint in a sky. Things just keep on going. I tell you. It's been something. Oh my gosh. Man. It's been quite a struggle here on just about everything. Lots of things. I may not even get this to cover properly like I want. I'm just using a piece of paper right now, which I probably should have used a canvas. I'm probably going to regret this because it's already buckling. You know what? I'm just going to get a canvas. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Hold the phone. It's not going to work properly for me, so bear with me. My easel broke on me, and so that's just one of the things, and that's mild. Let's see if I can back out a little bit. Hopefully you can see all that now. Let's start over here. I got gummed up paint. Kind of a mess. Hope everybody's doing. We're gonna get going here in a second. I tell ya, we are gonna get it together. Man, it's just a hot mess. It's a hot mess over here. And I need this. So, all right, here we go. We're gonna get started. So, just put some blue on your background. Get that up there, and then I can tighten it. There. Just get a basic blue in the background. That's all you need, because these birdhouses are going to be up on pedestals. These are just kind of fun to do. Make sure there's no white showing. Completely cover your canvas. Brush bristles off of there. Okay, if you got some variegated colors here, we're gonna add some clouds before we go into the birdhouses. So, I'm just gonna use the same brush. Oh, just a minute. I better turn that down. I'm not even, I don't even have it all gotten together yet. And I'm going to have to change a brush. I don't like how that was coming out. I'm just smashing this on right now. I don't like that, how that bristle was leaving a funny mark. Put your lighter color on the top of the clouds, because the light is coming from up above. I gotta get that switched here. This is just a fun, whimsical painting we can do. I don't remember the last painting I did. Well, let's add some darkness. A little bit maybe underneath here. We don't want it to be rain clouds, but just a little bit of a shadow here. Just dabbing it in. Gives it a little bit more depth. So now I'm going to take, I'm so tempted to use my palette knife right now at this point, but I'm going to take my short, oh, where's my rag? I'm going to take my short, bright, stiff bristled one. Actually, let's use... It's kind of a medium liner brush, but we're going to outline, take some black and water it down, because we're going to be making lines. And roll it into a point. So you want three houses. So do you want two lower ones or two higher ones? What do you want in the middle? Do you want the lower one in the middle, or do you want the higher one in the middle? I think I'm going to do the two higher ones. Okay, first, let's go about here. And we're just going to do a box. Let's get them where we want them. So let's just do a quick outline. This one maybe a little taller. Or bigger, I mean. And then the center one, let's make him a little more elaborate. Let's just do your box. Okay. And we're going to go. We're literally just making a box, because these up here are basically going to have a little bit more depth to them also. So right. So let's work on that center one first, and we'll get his shape on there first. I just, I'm not having enough room here for stuff. All right, so let's see. Let's put a roof on him. Now the back side is going to be the same, but you have to have a peak on it. All right, and let's put the whole. We'll be painting them, but let's just get an idea of where stuff is. This one, let's do a little bit weird. Let's go like this for the roof. And let's see. So he's going to have a flat roof. I don't know if you remember or ever did geometric designs or shapes in school, but this kind of goes back to that. And we can have two in this one. And this one. Let's see. One a little different than the other one. Let's try to make them just a little wider. We'll make them a little wider. Don't worry about, we can paint over top of that. So, and let's see. Your All right, we got our shapes. Okay, I want to make a ledge on, let's do a ledge on this one. Now let's bring our posts down, go in the center of the, doesn't have to be straight. I mean, if you want to do straight, the thing is to use a ruler, and I'll show you how to do that. You can line this up and just like that. I think I'm gonna go a little bit off to the side of this one. It does help. If you are anal, which it's not a bad thing about being centered, you can sure use this method. I don't even know if I'm straight. But anyway, that's, we have to, since this has a larger base, we are going to bring that post back behind here a little bit. Oop, didn't make it there. So this one is more of a square post, and the other two will just look like they're round. doodle and fiddle. So, let's decide our birdhouse colors. I'm gonna go red. I'll go red, and we already have a blue sky, so probably green. So just color them in. I need a different brush. I'm gonna go back to my flat. So now, if you want to get very, very precise, you can. Round that hole a little bit. Don't worry if you don't get the exact hole. We're going to be adding some more color and depth to these birdhouses as we go, so don't worry about completely filling them in. Let's add some brown. We're going to put a little bit of shadows under here before we bring that. See, that gives it a depth. Can you see that darkness? Just gonna have a little bit of a, let's go ahead and color that center in. I'm gonna need black. And you can color the ledge. Make sure that one side comes behind that, behind the birdhouse. And just like dominoes, they all fall down. Black. Let's put a dark brown roof on it, so I'm mixing black and brown. And let's extend that past that ledge, or I mean past that line of the birdhouse, okay? Too much stuff on my brush here. All right, that's good enough color now. Let's use the rest of that. If you have a bunch on your brush, so use your black and your brown. And let's go down one side here of the post. And it's mixed black and brown. Don't worry if it's like different colors. We're gonna leave the darkness of that post up here dark, because we're gonna come back with a little bit of white and accent that a little bit. So just get your colors in. Little bit of a edge. And we can leave that one be. I want to bring that roof down a little bit there. Alright, so I'm going to clean out my brush. Let's go to the other one. Let's do a green next. Maybe we'll do yellow. We'll do a yellow and then a green. I think this one will look kind of cool. You guys can paint them whatever color you want. Okay, then take a little bit of brown with that yellow. We're going to do that same thing we did over here. Let's add that shadow down here. Let's add a little bit up here along the sides of that roof. Okay, and this side is going to be a little bit darker anyway. So let's go ahead and just bring that down. I'm going to go back to that red and brown and do a little bit more over here. Just make it a little bit darker. Bring that shadow, maybe even touch of black. Okay, so then we can, let's do that roof, let's do a little bit of a lighter roof. So I'm using some white and the brown. You guys, just use your basic brown. I'm using burnt umber, cerulean blue, cadmium red, oxide green, white, black so far, and yellow ochre, if you're wondering what the... colors were. So I don't know that I'm liking that color for a roof. We might be changing. Let's... All right, we're just going to go, let's just add black in there. Let's just add black. And see how I'm just leaving the streaks in there? You guys, can you see my brush is full just of gunk? So I hardly ever wipe my brush off. Bring that other side of that roof down and a little bit in. Looks like hair. Looks like a wig. It's okay. It's all right. Okay, so let's go to the post and back to the black and the a little bit of red. Black and the brown. Let's do the one side darker. And I got a little bit of red in there. I'm not going to worry about it. It's okay. So you don't have to get too picky. Because, I mean, if you guys want to completely fill in, that's fine. But this is, I'm just getting some layers in there. I'm going to go ahead and use this in my brush over here. Get it used up. Don't worry if you go out of the lines. I'm not a line follower, I don't know if you guys are. Okay, see, that's what I wanted. We might make this red one a tad bit bigger, meaning we might bring it out a little bit more. Make him a little bit bigger. And then we got to bring that brown back in and shade that. All right, back to this one. And it's going to be green. Did I get green out? Nope. So I'm mixing in a little bit of yellow, the yellow ochre with the green, because I want this front side a little bit lighter for the first layer. And then just go into straight green for the side of it. Okay, and should we go completely black roof on that one? This is just a fun little thing. Like I said, you can make these on just about anything. That in. So this morning, anybody ever had sewer issues? I battle this twice a year. It's the neighbor's tree has grown. My sewer line runs over into their property, and their tree has grown, and the roots have pushed and are collapsing my sewer line. So there's a section that dips and everything collects and then builds and builds and builds and builds, and pretty soon I'm clogged all the time. And so they had to come today again and undo it. And so now I'm looking at a replacement cost, which is, I'm giving it to God, because he's got to help me come up with something. Come up with a plan. And, so we gotta, so anyway, they were here all this morning. It took like a long time too. They were out there, and then they had to come inside, and they had, of course, it's like just right over here next to me. And so I had to stop painting, and it kind of, it's my birthday today, so I was planning on just hanging out and painting and just having a nice relaxing day, which, and sharing with you guys. And then we had to deal with that. And of course, you know, you're tested all the time. And so I hope they're going to talk to some guy and see, give me an estimate on a replacement, and we're gonna go from there. That looks so funny. It looks like hair. It's too funny. All right, now we can go back and work on each one individually. So if you guys want to add some little, like, I don't put grass down here because it's going to look like they're very short, but once we get the post done, let's add some vines and go up around the post. But let's finish them up. I need white. I need lots of white. It's real hard to get, like, completely all the rest of it out. So I almost want to go with the, so tempted to use the palette brush, but so I'm just lightly dragging that brush down. And I paint this way anyway, so it's up to you. Even though some of this blue is going to show through, you guys can completely fill them in solid, but that is not really a big deal to me, so I'm not going to worry about that. But you guys can. So I'm staying with the right side, putting some highlight on that right side. That was too much. I'll come back with that. It's not a big deal. I'm just lightly dragging that up so we can get some variation in the wood. And it's okay here. I'm going to come back over top of it, so it's not a big deal. This, we got to put that edge back on. So I might as well use that while we have it. And I'm taking advantage of the white on here already. So, I mean, if you guys want to put some streaks in, you can. Let's see. Now let's go to the black and the brown. Dab them together, and let's go to the dark side. I don't know what I want to say here. Let's give that a shadow. Same with all the rest of them. But now on this one, I'm going to bring that back up into it. Just kind of dull that white down a little bit. There. And this one. Now, while you have the black and the brown on your brush, go back here and bring that shadow down, though, because the sun is up above on these houses, so you need to show a little bit of a shadow. They're old rustic posts, so let's calm this guy down a little bit. There we go. Doesn't need to be that bright. Alright. We can lighten up a little bit or even bring some of that yellow ochre into the brown. And add that for a little bit more dimension. Color into those posts. There, I'm really liking them. So let's work on that shelf a little bit. Since I'm liking this, that side's gonna be dark, so let's add a little bit of light on that front ledge. And we can keep this dark. I don't know how I got red. It's okay. They always say it's just paint. All right. So let's go ahead and just continue to work. I'm not ready to put the vines on those posts yet. I still want to add in a little bit more light. Let's bring in some white on that far side and we'll blend it over. A definitive line where that, I know I said they were going to be round, but they are square posts, so let's bring in a line that shows that. Not happy with that yet. Let's bring that shadow on those posts down a little bit more. And let's say that our light source is coming from that direction. So we can bring it down farther on the left side. Then on the right side. If your colors are blending, that's what you want, so it's not a big deal. Alright, now let's work on the, I almost said dollhouses. Let's work on the houses and get them to where we want them. Let's go ahead and bring in just a hint of maybe a ledge. Just a small ledge. Nothing like that one. Just something small. And we can find it with a little bit of black. And we could come back with a little bit of that blue. when you move, that's going to be purple. I'm going to kind of cover this, shorten this up a little bit here. It doesn't take me long to lose a brush, let me tell you. And let's bring that. I don't think I'd have it dark enough. Then let's bring that edge back, just like that. Now, I want to get my other, a smaller brush. I don't know if I want that one. Let me find it. This one. Alright. So let's mess with that red birdhouse a little bit. Let's bring in some red and brown. And play with this side a little bit. The top is going to be a little bit darker too, because it's going to be shaded. Let's bring in some white. Just load up your brush, but then wipe it off so it's just on the tips, because we want streaks. Put some on the other side, just there. Now, you have this on your brush. Imagine that you can see, here's the circle, but inside here, you're gonna do like a half moon, and that's the inside of that wood. Just a hint of it. If you want to use a smaller brush, go for it. This, I think I'm going to do that. So you can add a little bit of white, yellow ochre, and some brown. And make that little half moon. And then that gives that doorway some depth, like you can look into it. Show you. Do you see the half moon? Yeah. Okay. We're going to do that on all the doors, but we're going to darken them up. So let's work on that roof of the red birdhouse. I want to bring that way down yet. I don't know that I'm happy with it right there. And we had a little bit of white in there. I gave it a little bit of a streak. Okay. I'm losing my darkness, so let's go back and get some black and brown again. And I'm going to go back to the black. And get some black streaks in there. Let's make this an edge over here. And if you can, from this roof, go into the birdhouse because that roof angles back. Okay. So keep remembering your light source is coming from this direction over here. So it's shining this way. And you can come back and put, you know, put your lines on the sides to kind of define the birdhouse a little bit more. But as far as I'm concerned, this red birdhouse is pretty much done. So we can put some shadow in the front. I would say this one is pretty much done. If you want to add more to it, that's fantastic. You can put the little perch on there if you want. And I wouldn't go too elaborate. I would just make a stick. And I put a shadow underneath that. Okay. So let's go to the yellow one. Oops. Can you see it still? I know. I'm trying to get this at a decent. Sorry. Gotta look at my ugly mug. I have one light bulb out, so it's not doing the best for me as far as quality lighting. Things have been so wonky this last couple weeks. It's been so hard to go live with all the things and things not working. So I just thought, I'm just going to go and this is what we're going to do. And that's how it is. And it's how it's going to be because it's so frustrating because things just aren't working. All right. So I darkened up that one side, but I'm going to go ahead and load up my brush. And let's bring that pretty yellow up and around and fill in nicely. And even though I put that shadow up there, I'm still going to add some more of this up here. It just gives it more depth, more layers. That you do. And then we can use it to come up over here. Now I'm going to do the inside, the holes, the doorways. Did it brown, but now I'm going to come in with some black. probably have to let it dry a little bit. So let's go ahead and work on that roof. Don't forget to come back, bring that roof back in to the birdhouse. It has to be angled back in. This still looks short over here. For some reason, I just... keep extending it. Let's bring some yellow ochre up into that roof. This side, remember, is our light side. The top would be a little bit of this. Seriously, looks like a wig. Looks like a wig to me. Let me bring some white in just to highlight. Some highlights. Now I think that might be dry enough. Let's come back in with that black. That dry so we can put that half moon of lighter color on the one side. So let's go ahead and get this one. Add some white. Now how we did the streaks on this, let's add the white streaks on the yellow ochre birdhouse. too. Kind of gives it more, more things to look at. One spot got a little bright for me, so I'm just going to bring some back over top of that. Okay. Now, I think, hold on. Now let's get some yellow ochre. Actually, let's use that liner brush and get some yellow ochre and do that half moon just inside the doorways. Now, since this is yellow ochre already, white to it. So it stands out a little bit more. You want to add the perches. You can add the perches. I'm going to go with yellow. Actually, let's go with the dark brown. I have dark brown. And then some white. And a little bit of black and brown to bring in that shadow that's kind of down below and around. Okay. Now, I think we'll let that set. Let's go to the green one. And let's get some black and green, so it's kind of a forest green. And let's do this side. We want that darker. And some shadows up in here. Don't worry, we'll be bringing the green back. Okay, so green. So I'm going to start from the bottom on that edge and come up Let's bring an edge to this side. Kind of define it. Now let's mess with that roof while that green dries, because we're going to bring in streaks of white again. Let's hit our block. Make a shadow underneath that other side of that roof, even though you're using black, because that is creating a shadow under that roof flap. So now I'm leaving the black in my brush, but I'm bringing a little bit of white into some brown. And that I'm going to use to make that the roof edges in the front. More. And let's go back to the black and come back and get that edge here. Make it a little bit more defined. And bring it up. Then let's grab the white. And make that highlight on the roof. Don't do too much because you don't want it to look like snow. Okay. Now let's go ahead and do the streaks in the green. So make sure you have your brushes dry and you are dabbing in the white. Oh, I got blue on. And I just start at the bottom again and come up. Like that. Now I think let's do the half moon. In the doorway. You can use, I'm running out of brown. If it's black, you can use what's going to look better if you have it completely black inside, or do you have it brown? Now, if you have it brown inside, you're going to want to go with yellow ochre and lighten that edge up a little bit. Now, if you have it black inside, you can go with a layer of yellow ochre and then your burnt umber on top like I just did. And again, if you want a perch. Now, use your liner brush. I'm going to leave that one in the water. We're going to do some vines. So use your liner brush, get in your green, get it watery, and roll your liner brush into a tip, into a fine point. All right. Now we're going to go around in front and stop. Okay, twirl it around in front and stop at the side. Continue on the other side. Stop at the side. You're doing S's pretty much. Okay, did you see that? And you can make them tighter, you can make things where there's leaves coming off of them. Make flowers coming off of them, whatever you want. Kind of looks like Jack and the Beanstalk, doesn't it? So let's get the next one. Let's start from, maybe we'll have two on this one. I don't know. Twirly. And again, add your little stems for your leaves or whatever you're going to add, flowers. So then the last one, since we went this way, let's do the opposite way here. Now you can come in and add some black to the underneath sides of those vines and give them a little more depth. A vine here. Some stems on there. Now on the other side of this, we just put some black on there on the bottom side. Let's add some white with yellow ochre. Lighten it up, and we can touch and give the top sides of these vines a little bit of a highlight. Like that. So I think what I'm going to show you guys now, you can either do leaves or flowers. I'm going to do them on the one post and you guys can finish up, and that way you don't have to watch me do the other two. If you want to put a bird on the middle one, you can. I'm not going to do it today. I can always come back and show you another time. Go back. Let's see. Go back and watch that video of the cardinal on the branches. I did do a cardinal. I think that is in the canvas paintings. So you can look that up in the canvas paintings. All right. So let's just do some leaves. Now I'm doing yellow and green here, and I'm just doing a teardrop shape. And add two leaves to one stem. Now these are very hard to see from there. Let's see if I can show you. Here's what I'm doing. So you got your vine and you have your stem. I'm just doing a teardrop shape, just like that. And I'm coloring it in, and now you can go to the extent of adding black around the bottom to give it a height, you know, your depth, and then you can bring in the yellow and tip it on top for a highlight. So, all right, that's all I'm doing for the leaves. So, I'm gonna keep adding a few more, and then I might add a flower here and there. Keep adding a few leaves though. And keep using that yellow and green mix. If you can't do a teardrop shape, do a spade shape. It's, or a kind of like a tiger eye shape. This has been fun. It's a cute little, like I said, you can use them on just about anything. I thought about painting them on a bucket. I just might do that yet. All right, let's just do some quick little flowers. It doesn't have to be anything special. So I have some red left on here. So I think I'm just gonna mix some white into this red and make some pink. And we'll just use that up. You don't have to do nothing special, you can make them little. Just something that looks like a flower. Just here and there. This is all I'm doing. Maybe in the nook of say right there. I'm just almost doing a starburst. That's all I'm doing. And you can get more elaborate than that if you want. If your brush cooperates. You put two together. Then I'm just going to add a little bit of a center to the middle of that flower. Maybe like a the brown and the yellow ochre, and just dab a little bit of a center in there with that, and then we'll come back. I don't think that's dark enough. Let's go darker. I'm using more brown. They don't have to be perfect. You're just giving a likeness. Do they look like a flower? Sure. Are they exactly like a flower? No. Okay. So I'm going to hold this up. Hi, Sandy. So I'm going to hold this up. Hopefully you can see it closer. And then you guys can finish up the other vines, but there you go. You can add as many little flowers, as many little leaves as you want. And you can, you can be more of a perfectionist on this. You can do it more square and all that. I just like to freely paint and go with it. So you guys have fun with this one. I can't wait to see your guys' rendition. Please share when you get them done. And thank you so much for watching. And you guys have a great day. And thanks for spending the day with me on my birthday. Take care.